Good, everybody. JV, let's back at y'all with a reaction video. Subscribe to my channel, hit the like button. Any videos y'all want me to react to, hit me up. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, the Stardust app. At JVLord77, what I'm about to react to is this week's top 10 moments of SmackDown Live. Now, we had the first part of the Superstar Shakeup as people from SmackDown coming to Raw, 205 Live, NXT. And we got some names and we got some surprises. The War Raiders. A big surprise, and there were some names mentioned like later on, like after SmackDown. So it was pretty interesting. So we gonna see what's gonna happen on the SmackDown side. Like, you know, a lot of speculation, you know, and there are some things that happened, you know, with some superstars that I'll talk about after this. So let's just go ahead and get to this top 10. And then I'll do some more talking about the Superstar Shakeup and cats asking for their release after this. So let's get it. Like I say, a lot of people predicted Finn was coming to SmackDown, and yes, Finn is the here.
In these high risk situations, this is hazardous territory for Ali and Balor. Oh, down goes Balor. Some authority behind that one. Ali may pull this off. Ali trying to get to the cover, hook to the inside leg. Balor able to kick out at two.
You guys are used to being a trio. With Biggie not here, I think it's time you guys enlist the help of Big O right here.
Honorary member.
No, please. Please, for the love of all things holy.
Man, that liberty ass shirt.
There it is.
Man, they could get this dude a bigger shirt. What the hell?
Has he no self-respect? This is his hometown crowd. The Big O has just been
he being knighted. Man, it's some up, down, down shit right here. Silliness, man.
WWE Women's Tag Team Champions. First, Asuka and her partner, Kairi Sane.
Kairi Sane got the call up. Now, people was hoping that it was going to be EO too. So that lets you know that they plan on keeping EO in NXT for a while. That she's going to be going after that championship. So basically, it's going to be Shayna, Bianca, and EO, and probably Candice LeRae fighting for that NXT Women's Championship. Asuka and Kairi is a team, so Asuka's not going after the championship no more, right? That's interesting, man. SmackDown women roster now is stacked. They went Raw went from having the best women roster tonight at SmackDown. So Lars Sullivan went from Raw to SmackDown. So is he gonna be on NXT tonight? And he got a new finisher, huh? Running powerbomb. I get him a new finisher too. That man, big head motherfucker, man. Shit. Yeah, he'll separate your shoulder, getting you a headbutt from the top rope. Get it? Nice. Ooh. Finn's had two back-to-back tough matches against Sammy and Ali. So, I think Finn gonna lose his title pretty soon, and then he's gonna go up to the heavyweight championship, the WWE championship. Kyrie, give him the elbow, throw them bows. Yeah, the Iconics, y'all losing them belts pretty soon. Hey, nice teamwork. Okay, when's the heel turn? The big dog. Man, Roman all on his own now. Yeah, SmackDown definitely gonna be Roman's show. Boom! Chill, Vince. Chill, Vince. Welcome to SmackDown, Elias. That was beautiful.
I don't care what he says. SmackDown Live is my yard now.
Yeah. Yeah, Kofi, you might have a problem. Shit, because people are like, yeah. A lot of these people with belts might be losing their titles pretty soon, but I am hoping for a long Kofi reign. Can we get this man to SummerSlam? And like I say, man, when is the heel turn coming for Kevin Owens, man? We know it's coming. We know it's coming. All right. Luke Harper asked for his release, and it was funny because he was just talking about how he'd been ready since February. And damn, like I say, man, that dude been a tag team champion, been an intercontinental champion. No, he's had Eric Rowan has had numerous injuries, but a dude who could have been a lot more, man, and he gone. And then, man, I was talking, man, Andre on Twitter was talking about this Sanity thing, man, the way they fucked up Sanity. Sanity was doomed the moment it got the call up. Wasn't on TV for shit. Didn't bring Nikki Cross with him. Didn't make no impact. You saw these dudes some couple of weeks ago getting worked by the Miz, all three of them, man. Eric Young is coming to Raw. Is he going to be repackaged or what? Nikki's still in limbo. We don't even know where Nikki's going to be yet, because she hasn't been put with no brand. And a lot of people are probably putting together that hun, Bray Wyatt, you know, them little puppets and dolls that they may be together or something. Alexander Wolf, man, I guess he just said, fuck it, man. Like, you know, he kind of phrased it like, you know, a new chapter. So he was trying to do something different than wrestling. And then Killian Dane, where's Killian Dane going? Is he going to NXT UK? Because he ain't been mentioned on Raw SmackDown. So he must be going to NXT UK or back to NXT. But like I say, man, Sanity will be one of the biggest mistakes WWE has ever made, as far as dropping the ball. So I think it's obvious Joe is going to Raw. They going to put the U.S. title on Raw. I think it's obvious, so I'm not even worried about that. You know, like I say, Bray still a mystery. I guess Sammy is going to be on Raw, you know. But like I said, man, we got some additions, you know. Overnight, Heavy Machinery, they going to be on SmackDown. Because when I think about it, man, I was expecting the Revival or somebody to go to SmackDown, because it's like the SmackDown tag team division and kind of went down. You know? It kind of went down. The Raw tag team division is off the chain now. Man, Usos, Revival, Aleister Black and Ricochet. Shit, AOP still over there. You know what I mean? Hawkins and Ryder, the B team still over there. Like, fuck. You know, they broke up the Riot Squad. Well, Liv Morgan's coming to SmackDown, so it's like, what's that gonna be like? You know, it's crazy, man. It is absolutely crazy. Like I say, Roman, obviously the big acquisition, Elias, Finn Balor, Lars Sullivan, Ember Moon. Oh, I wanted Ember Moon. Ember Moon could be, well, Ember Moon could have, she could have stayed on Raw. But I expect big things out of Ember Moon. And like I say, though, SmackDown's women division is super fucking stacked right now. But it's like, are we going to establish, are these, and when you think about it, SmackDown's women's division, is that might as well be the specific home for the women's tag team championships, because other than the Riot Squad, there's no tag teams on Raw with the women that's left. They're going to have to makeshift teams. You know what I mean? You know, with Nia hurt, so Tamina solo, Naomi don't have a partner. We don't know if Bev coming back, Natty solo. It's just the Riot Squad. Becky going to do her solo dolo thing. Selena on her own. Lacey on her own. It's like SmackDown. So they might have to make a fucking mid-core title for Raw for the women, for something for these other chicks to do, because since all these girls are individuals, except for Ruby and Sarah, that everybody's going to be going after the damn title. You know? But it's like a lot of people going to be able to like get some shine. That's right. Dana's still there. Mickie James, she went to SmackDown. You know, Bayley went to SmackDown. You know, so that must mean that whenever Sasha comes back, she's going to Raw. So that will help, because I'm looking at, obviously, Becky. If Becky loses the title on Raw, she'll stay on Raw. Because you're looking at Becky, Sasha, Naomi, Lacey. And, you know, that's the big four right there. You know, and then somebody, Ruby Riott, them the big five, and everybody else going to have to, like, fall into place. You know, Kairi Sane, you know, Big Asian, Buddy Murphy. Buddy Murphy proved himself so much. Chad Gable and Apollo Crews, man. I want so much for these dudes. And it's like, what is their place going to be? You know, are they actually going to do something with these dudes? Because Apollo Crews, man, is so talented, man. This cat could do so fucking much, man. Hopefully they use him right on SmackDown. And like I say, Heavy Machinery, that definitely will help the tag team division over there on SmackDown. So, yeah, it's a lot, man. I'm just looking over the rosters, you know. I don't know what the fuck, like I said, on the top 10 Raw, man, EC3 might as well ask for his release, because he getting played. I'm expecting big things out of Cedric Alexander, you know, on Raw, showcase his talents. Rey Mysterio there. Andrade, big things for him. You know, Raw Tag Team Division, like I said, is fucking stacked. You know, The Miz over there. AJ Styles there. So, I know a lot of people probably feel that the shakeup was underwhelming, but, you know, it is a lot of potential for some people, man. It is a lot of potential for some people to get some shine. And like I say, if SmackDown go to 3 hours on Fox, it'll make it even more better for these people, man. And one last thing on the women's division for Raw. The next NXT call-ups you see women-wise, they definitely going to go to Raw. So Shayna definitely would go to Raw. There's no doubt in my mind about that. You know, so there y'all have it, man. Let me know what y'all think about the shakeups. You know, like I say, we are officially reset. So let's fucking get it. Let's start this 2019 journey. And like I said, we got Money in the Bank next month. So we're going to be seeing who's going to get the briefcase and going to be laying in wait for these titles. So there y'all have it. So with that being said, subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button. JV Lewis. Y'all be safe out here. Catch y'all on the rebound. And I'll see y'all good people next video. Peace.